This is a time where God initiated by himself as an act, a sovereign act.
Este es un tiempo que Dios mismo inició como un momento soberano.
And during these set times, heaven aligned with earth.
Y durante estos tiempos picos, el cielo se alinea con la tierra.
There's a portal in the heavens open.
Hay un portal en los cielos abierto.
This is the time where God, our four set time, don't change.
Estos son tiempos fijados donde no nada cambia.
It reveals the purposes of God.
Que revela los propósitos de
But
Dios.
Literally, this feast of Passover,
pero literalmente esta fiesta
what represent for those of you that are watching?
¿Qué representa para aquellos que están mirando?
Because God speaks through the feast.
Porque Dios habla a través de las fiestas.
Every time there is a feast, there is an open heaven.
Siempre que hay fiesta, hay cielos abiertos.
The heaven is aligning with earth.
Los cielos se alinean con la tierra.
And what represent this prophetically to us?
¿Y qué representa esto proféticamente a nosotros?
Freedom from sin.
Libertad del pecado.
And how the Jewish people would deliver from slavery.
Y como el pueblo judío fue liberado.
Number two, freedom from the Egyptian economy.
Liberación de la economía de Egipcio.
So in other words, this feast represents.
En otra palabra, esta fiesta representa.
If you are bound to being a slave to economy, to the economy of this world.
Que estás en este momento atado a la economía.
We must come into the economy of God. Egypt represents the world, is the type of the world system.
El Egipto representa el mundo, el sistema del mundo.
So this is the opportunity God has given us to come out of that Egyptian thinking and Egyptian economy.
Apostle?
Yes.
Can I say something about
that? That's yes, very... no, please interrupt whenever you want.
No, because we're both going to interact.
Yes. This,
what Apostle just said, from a theological point of view, is about 6 weeks worth of teaching. Most people don't fully understand it. Let me say this, because Apostle and I, we're both going to develop this for everybody to hear this. There's predispositions regarding the feast. There's the fundamentals regarding the feast, and the church fundamentally believes the principles of Passover, our salvation. But then there's the prophetic aspect of the feast. Mm-hmm. Now, right now, we're at a prophetic time.
Yes. You know, we're in a prophetic
time. Oh, I'm so sorry. Daniel, you got to jump in. I'm so sorry.
Okay, Apostle. El Apostle Maldonado recién estaba compartiendo. Son 6 semanas de enseñanzas profundas. Entonces vamos a tomar hay tres diferentes aspectos y lo vamos a tomar ahora por el aspecto profético que Dios está haciendo a través de esta fiesta.
Yes, and so we've got the fundamental part of it.
Tenemos la parte fundamental.
And then we've got the revelatory part of it.
Tenemos la parte de la revelación.
Dale más rápido.
And the prophetic part of it.
La parte profética.
So, Apostle, I want to ask you this question because we know a lot of people, but I would say I'm prophetically disappointed with most people who are saying they're prophetic. Because they don't have a clear directive from God.
Porque no tiene una dirección clara de Dios.
And so I'm going to ask you as an apostle to the nation, I'm going to ask you this key question.
Yes.
At this Passover, what is God saying prophetically to the church and to the nations?
Well, I think we must understand something, as you were saying about the foundation of the feast.
Creo que debemos entender algo como usted ha hablado de los fundamentos de la fiesta.